private retreat outside Sapparo, Hokkaido, Japan. This place has relocated Zerkheizi to Hokkaido, Japan. Evidence suggests that a faction within this place may be acting without authorization. Kidnap Zerkheizi so Third Echelon can find out what he knows and what Displace's involvement is. And greetings for the Earthlings. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. This level is probably one of my favorite levels in this game, just because of how it makes you feel like an actual ninja, because of, you know, the Japanese ambiance and the setting. And this is actually the first level where there are actual fire, like lights based around fire rather than electricity, meaning that our OCP will not be as effective in this level as it is in others. However, fire lights made out of fire are also not as bright. They leave a lot of shadows around the area, which we do seek to exploit. Now, this level in itself is a little difficult. I mean, I already told you guys that, well, penthouse onwards is where the game will begin to get challenging. This level in itself is sort of moderate difficulty. Not that any of the levels in Chaos Theory are too difficult, but yeah, they do escalate in difficulty, and this level is a little difficult. With that being said, I can't speak today. What happened thus far was that, well, somebody kidnapped a scientist called Morgan Holt to fish out information about the mass kernel from them. He got killed in the process, and even though we tried to rescue him, all we could do was delete the data. And to tie up any loose ends, we also deleted the person who was contracted to kidnap him. From there onwards, we still needed to figure out who was behind this entire thing, who actually contracted the person to, you know, kidnap and torture Morgan Holt. So we turned our attention towards a bank, and from the bank we found the name of this one person called Zerkheizi, who was working alongside Morgan Holt looking for, you know, well, essentially he was working on the mass kernels alongside Morgan Holt, which is a little surprising because he was working alongside Morgan Holt. So what could he glean from Morgan Holt, though, is my question. But at any rate, this person is somehow involved in, you know, all of this. And well, raiding his penthouse revealed to us that Displace is essentially a part in all of this, and they have been protecting Zerkheizi. So we head over to Displace, and well, we do find the link between Displace and Zerkheizi, and the trail suggests that he has been relocated to Japan, to Hokkaido, to be exact. And yeah, we essentially need to kidnap Zerkheizi, either, you know, rescue him if he's being held hostage by a splinter faction of Displace, or by force kidnap him if he's actually working alongside a splinter faction in Displace. It's still not clear at this point whether the entirety of Displace is involved in all of this, or whether it is just a splinter faction, but I suppose that is why this game is called Splinter Cell. So, here we go.
As happy as we are to be back online here in New York, our thoughts turn to our loved ones who are defending us on this beautiful 4th of July. We go now live to the Yellow Sea, where sailors aboard the USS Clarence E. Walsh are celebrating. We have Seaman Anthony Palmiera from Brooklyn, New York. Tell us, Seaman Palmiera, how you'll be celebrating Independence Day.
Well, the captain's going to have a big barbecue on deck, and tonight we'll have our own fireworks.
Talk to me! Captain, all of our command systems crashed. Nothing's responding.
Seaman Palmiera, can you tell us what's happening there?
Sit tight, Sam. I'll call you back.
It's the Koreans, Mr. President. I recommend that we declare war immediately.
If it was Korea, there would be 200,000 men coming over the DMZ right now.
Maybe it was an accident. Maybe an exercise. A test launch gone wrong.
That's impossible. The Koreans can't even detect the Walsh, never mind track it on radar and sink it with a 30-year-old Chinese anti-ship missile.
I have reason to believe the ship was crippled with an information warfare attack.
Not a chance. The Walsh's systems are...
unhackable? The Walsh's EW suite is built on kernels first identified by two of the world's leading computational theorists. One of them was found dead in Peru last week. I'm about to pick up the other one.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not sure what we've just witnessed here, but I'm afraid something terrible
has occurred.
Amazing what they show on TV these days, huh, Sam? World's gone crazy.
I guess you're in the right business then, Doug.
What are you doing here?
I'm looking for a guy named Milan Nedich. Heard he works for you.
Lots of people work for me. Haven't you heard? First security company to make the Fortune 500. If you're looking for a job.
I'm not.
Is that so? You keep doing what you're doing, you'll just end up another unknown soldier.
I'm not in it for the fame. Your buddy Nedich is dirty. Cut him loose.
Unlike other employers, I don't cut people loose. If you got evidence against one of my guys, I'll help you bring him in. But I'm not gonna send a man up the river because you say so.
Fair enough. Just stay out of my way.
Thanks for the advice. In case you change your mind.
Fisher, if I can't throw the Joint Chiefs a bone, we'll be at war in the next 24. I need you to bring in Zerkheizi for questioning. Milan Nedich has moved him to Hokkaido for protection. I have no idea if Shetland is aware or involved, but I'd like to find out. However it turns out, don't let your personal concerns get in the way.
In my opinion, there are too many coincidences here. Zerkheizi is the only living person who could have orchestrated the sinking of the Walsh. Even if the Koreans did launch the missile, it would almost certainly have required Zerkheizi's help to actually hit the ship. And this business with Displace... I know you don't want to hear it, but I think Shetland's dirty. The kidnapping of Morgenholt, the protection of Zerkheizi, relocating him after the blackout, it stinks.
Looks like Displace rented out the entire retreat. It's low-tech and quiet. Don't expect servers and security. Expect aware guards, in tune with the environment. You're going to need to rely on more traditional methods. Up close and personal.
Just the way I like it.
Japanese ISDF conducts a low-level monitoring of the activities of anyone employed by a PMC for as long as they are in the country. We discovered yesterday that Displace has rented this retreat, and a number of our agents planted microphones in the location. Unfortunately, we were not adequately prepared for the increased importance of the location. The microphones are detectable using standard tools. Needless to say, it would be best if Displace did not find them.
Right, so one of the notes that I want to make here is the fact that, well, Shetland butted out a cigar. You never do that with cigars. You just let it, you set it aside and let it burn out on its own. Otherwise, it just stinks up the entire room. Anyhow, that's a minor thing. So yes, right now the stakes are pretty high. You saw... Shetland, Sam confronting Shetland essentially, and well, Shetland was unwilling to give any confirmation about Milan Nedich, who apparently works for him, or set him loose. So, yeah, it's the onus falls upon us now to find any kind of evidence. Okay, so. We really don't need any rounds for this level. Might as well take the stealth loadout. I'm sort of sad that I missed the score bump in the previous level, but I would... well, I can only recover it in this level, to be honest.
Fisher, remember, I need you to bring in Zerkheizi alive.
What about Nedich?
Nedich is another story.
Isolate, simplify, complete.
We're on the same page?
Affirmative.
That being said, Nedich is still an opportunity objective, and there's a lamp up ahead that we cannot disable using our pistol, because, well, oh, it is an electronic lamp, apparently. Huh, what do you know? The more you know, I guess. Anyhow, let me just make a save here, because this first section is a little tricky. This card is difficult to, like, get past. I mean, we can wait around here, to be honest. We can wait here for that guy to head back, and then we can move along. I'm just going to do that instead of taking the light out. But yeah, this level does actually use... I mean, as beautiful as it is, it does use non-traditional lighting techniques as well. Yeah, so you better stick close to the wall, otherwise you're gonna get highlighted. Made a save there again, because this section is just that sensitive, to be honest. Cool. Wait, I thought... Never mind. So we're just gonna wait right under him here. pretty close, but oh well. Alright, this saying about how people tend to turn dumb once you put a camera in front of them, put them on camera, and I understand what they were saying right now. Back then, I mean. You have to be a little extra cautious. Oh, come on. Yeah, we can safely move now. This guy will not be able to see us. Cool. We're clear of that section. Had to save scum a lot there, but that is how it be. And... yeah, we are more or less free to proceed here. Still gonna make a save, because I'm not certain. Maybe there is like a surprise right here. In front of us, by the way, is a candle that we would better steer clear of.
Sam, use your EEV to scan the license plates on those trucks. I might be able to dig up some info on our friend Nedich.
I'll give it a shot.
And that's gonna leave some trails. Oh, not this truck. The ones in front of us, I see. The one with the guy standing in front of it, apparently.
Five-speed, 240 horsepower automatic transmission. 8-liter turbo diesel V8 with 460 foot-pounds of torque. Independent front and rear double A-frame suspension on a 6-quad steel box section. 4-wheel drive, ABS, and torque biasing differential with 40-to-1 gear reduction. Puncture-resistant 17-inch tires, quarter-inch aluminum rocker panel, and steel grid drivetrain protection. Windshield-projected infrared night vision heads-up display.
You guys done?
A 640-gig MP3 player. Standard. No one will ever need more than 640 gig. What are you talking about? Mine's almost full.
No dice. Nothing suspicious about... Wait a minute. The Bosnian barber.
I already have a barber, but I think he's Italian. That place next to the donut shop?
The leasing company papers list a dummy corporation created by one Milos Nowak, a.k.a. Milon Nedich. Nowak is a suspected war criminal from the Bosnian conflict. He's known as the Barber of Bosnia because he allegedly scalped some of his prisoners.
Well, I guess he won't be making an appearance in The Hague anytime soon.
Guess not.
Alright, I might be making a rather risky move here, but oh well. We need to get here anyway, so might as well just take this route. Exit through the front.
Oh, this squeaking is driving me crazy. Sounds like I'm walking on a family of
microphones. What a waste of time. Nobody uses hidden microphones to spy on anybody anymore. Satellites. This is so ridiculous. I feel like an idiot.
Yeah, so I think the first microphone will be somewhere over here. Unless it was over there, actually. I think it was over there, if I'm not wrong. In that regard, let me just go and wait here. I wanna go there and grab the first microphone. I do believe it was over there in that corner. Close. And this is where the microphone is.
That's the first microphone, Sam. Five more to go.
I'm on it.
Good job, Sam. Good job. On top of everything, huh? Alright, moving on. There's a guy in front of us. He's gonna come out soon, but I don't think we need to be worried though. I think not. I think we should just rather stay here instead. Oops, not the visual that I wanted.
Fisher, looks like this place has kept a small staff on to take care of the retreat.
Civilians?
That's right. Don't let any of them get killed.
I won't.
Right then. I think we are cool to stay here. I don't think any of these areas had any microphones, but...
You find any bugs?
Yeah, they're everywhere. I can't get rid of them. It's like a damn insectarium here.
I mean microphones, stupid.
Oh, well, I looked a bit, but I didn't find any.
A bit? What does that mean? Where did you look?
On the table and stuff.
You looked on the table for microphones?
Yeah.
Gee, did you find any?
No.
Never mind. I'll look for them myself.
Okay. Well, let me know if you need any help.
So that's another microphone. The microphones are inside the paintings, by the way. So, let me just go and make a save here.
Yeah.
Disabling the microphone is very easy. It's a planting one that's the difficult part. I think that is where we had to go, if I'm not wrong. There was like a tunnel of sorts that we could use to get where we wanted to. Making a save again, because why not? Yeah, right there. The crawl space, as this game likes to call it. Despite how beautiful this game is, especially in this level, it's sort of sad how you need to rely on, the night vision to actually see where you're going. But unless you have to do that, well, you're not really playing Splinter Cell. Alright. Jump up, grab it, and move. That guy is doing some kind of martial art there. I could not recognize it, but yeah, that is some kind of martial art that that guy is doing over there. Where are the lights? Why is it so illuminated that by, oh, by the sun, the sunset. Okay.
Hey, Wendell, have you seen Mylon?
Cannot say that I have.
Yeah, he just went through here with some of the guys. I think they're in a meeting. Why?
I just heard that Carl was looking for him.
Carl? I thought he was looking for microphones.
He is, I guess. You know Carl.
Yeah, good point.
Very risky move, and unless I was playing in realistic, if I was playing in realistic, I would not have succeeded with that. So the only way forward from here is to essentially get rid of this light. Let me make a save here, try going without doing that. Yeah, it's not really possible. Oh no. Will you stop looking at me? It's like these guys get so freaked out every single time somebody every single time like a leaf moves, these civilians, I mean the guards get cautious, but these civilians, they will lose their shit every single time like even leaf moves. I'm trying to not make anybody suspicious here, not to touch that light. I will observe the patrol patterns and act accordingly. I'm just waiting for this guy to move right now. That is an electric light, by the way. Just themed to look like a firelight. Are you just gonna stand there then? I suppose you are. That was my chance and I missed it.
It ain't supposed to do that, is it?
No, it is not.
6 weeks out of warranty and bam, the thing starts screwing up.
Okay, done. I was needlessly making things more complicated for myself.
Let's just forget it happened.
So we can reschedule this to there. Yes, right.
Ah, well, I'm not sure we can do it.
Yeah, but this is... That's... Okay. South Africans.
No, that's fine. An agreement we can...
No. I think we can commit to that. That'll be fine.
What about you? What do you think?
Yes? No. Yeah. No. Maybe.
So I'm just gonna get in here and,
Yeah, back to New York. Broker that deal.
So we can reschedule this to there.
Yeah, all right. Wait, there was another one right here. I forgot where exactly.
Yeah, but if he says...
No, not here. South
Africa. Got it. No, that's fine.
That's our exit.
I think we can commit... No, that'll be fine. What about you? What do you think?
Yeah. Yeah. No. Maybe. We'll see.
Where's the...
Alright. Yeah. Back to New York.
There was something here that we needed to...
So we can reschedule this to there.
No.
Yes. Right.
Hold up.
I'm not sure we can do
it. There was a mic in here that we needed to disable, if I recall correctly.
South Africans.
No. That's fine. An agreement we can live with.
I think we can commit to that. That'll be fine.
Interesting.
What about you? What do you think?
No.
I guess not.
Yeah. No. Maybe.
I'm just checking around the place, to be honest.
Yeah.
To try and find the mic, wherever that
so
might
we
be.
Can reschedule this there. Yes. Right.
Can't see any place that the mic
sure
might be.
All right.
Yeah, I guess it's not here then.
That's true. South Africans.
No. That's fine. An agreement we can live with.
I think we can commit to that. That'll be fine. What about you?
Alright then, moving on. The next section is probably the coolest section in this game.
No. Maybe. We'll see.
No.
Well...
Yeah, back to New York. Broker that deal.
So we can reschedule this to there. Yes, right.
Alright, listen up. That was Doug. He's on his way, and he's not happy.
What do you mean? He's on his way here?
Our offices got turned over in New York, and he's worried about a leak. He's coming up here to... tie up some...
Oops. Sorry.
Good one. They're only yen. Not worth anything since the market crashed.
Not even worth the effort
that
to pick
true.
Them up.
A penny saved.
The offices got hit. By who? The feds? Who cares about the offices? What's this tie up loose ends thing?
Not exactly sure. But this thing with the ship. Maybe someone's onto us.
But what if...
Look, never mind all that. The boss is on his way and things are heating up. We knew that would happen, so just stick to the plan, get this place tightened up, and make sure that this little visit goes off without a hitch. Get moving!
Is that Milan Nedich? It probably is. The thing is, he's talking about his boss coming over, and that is probably our cue to get out of here. Okay, a little too close for comfort there, sir.
No. No.
yeah. Please close that door.
No. No.
Are you not going to close it?
Alright.
Yeah, I'll wait for you to get out first.
Alright.
Come on then, get a move on. This door remains open, apparently.
Alright.
Come on, close it. Okay, you're gonna leave it open. Okay. So, this is probably the coolest part in all of Splinter Cell, but...
Okay.
Grab him. And I wanna... like, take out the light as well. I cannot do that. Oh no. Oh well. Whatever works, I suppose. Can I take him to this corner here? I hope I can. Yeah. Maybe turn him around a little.
Shh. Let's not make a scene.
Who are you? What do you want?
I want to know why you're protecting Zerkheizi. How Displace is involved.
I won't talk.
You're going to make me cut your throat and look for the words inside your neck.
Oh, damn.
God, please. Let me go.
You're not leaving here alive, Nedich. But if you tell me what I want to know, I can make the end a little easier for you.
The blockout. We needed to keep Zerkheizi safe after the blockout.
And what about the Walsh?
I don't know anything about the Walsh. You'll have to ask Shetland.
Shetland?
Yeah. He needed more data from Zerkheizi after the blockouts. But we have everything we...
Shetland knows what you're up to.
Yeah, yeah, he's the boss. He gave the order to bring Zerkheizi here.
Where is he now?
He's on his way here now, by helicopter.
I'm just gonna wait for that guy to come here, get settled at that thing over there, and then go back before I interrogate him further. Adds a sense of realism to everything, you know?
Jesus! This thing is ruined!
Yes, yes it is. So basically, Shetland is involved in all of this. No wonder he was not willing to sell out Milan Nedich, and Sam sort of made a mistake by confronting him. I'm sort of... because
all
now
clear.
Shetland... all clear. Yeah, probably the... Nedich probably fell through it and just disappeared. Yeah, so Shetland is now coming over by helicopter to take out loose ends, and you all know what that means. It means he's coming over to kill Zerkheizi, probably.
That's Nedich out of the picture, but we have a complication. There's a helicopter inbound. Shetland is aboard.
Doug, why is he coming here?
Either he was coming to see what Nedich is up to, or our assumptions are wrong.
You still think Shetland's crooked?
I still don't know, and that's what bothers me. Find out what Shetland and Zerkheizi are meeting about.
Alright then. Heading back on track. I'm gonna save you. And we are gonna be on our way. This guy in here. And, well, I don't know why, but let me just check again. I recall coming in here. Where's the mic? In the wall.
That's half of Otomo's microphone, Sam.
Yeah, I'll keep my eyes peeled for the rest.
Not what I wanted to do. So this is guy, that guy that's still patrolling around in the area. Who saw me? And how did you see me? Through the wall at that. I guess that speeds things along though. This guy looks like he's about to turn around.
Nothing.
Just ghosts and shadows. Anyway, this is the way I need to go. And we're clear. It's strange how that guy could manage to see me through the wall there. I remembered having to go inside that room and like disabling a mic, but there wasn't a, what do you call it? I really couldn't see the mic apart from in the... like, I couldn't see the mic in the EMF vision. Like this. So... and there wasn't a painting on top of it. I guess it was just one of those bonus objectives that the game didn't really want to talk about. We can turn the valve to turn on the water in this level. Not sure what it does, but I would rather not touch it. I'm just gonna wait for that guy to get a move on. North American tree slug in its natural habitat. There are two mics here right next to each other.
This voracious detrivore is considered by many to be simply a snail without a shell. Nothing could be further from the truth.
So yeah, there's this guy watching television right here.
The juggernaut-like forward motion of the North American tree slug, in the absence of his natural predators, is truly terrifying to behold.
Are you gonna move, sir? I hope you do.
Many an entomologist, ignorant of the raw animal power of the slug, has awoken in his tent to find his rare lichen samples partially devoured in only a few short hours.
Apparently just for that brief part, the... yeah, so there's a mic right here, and that guy is not really gonna move.
And there are many more kinds of slugs, all around us, everywhere.
Is there a mic in here? I do not think there is a mic in here. Maybe here? Nope, no mics here.
This voracious detrivore is considered by many to be simply a snail without a shell.
And I do believe there's a guy in there, like a mic in there. Yeah, right here.
Next.
Here we observe the North American tree slug in its natural habitat.
Hmm. Yes, yeah, so this next section is a little tricky because of how...
the juggernaut,
let's check. Is there a mic there?
North American tree slug
does not show up in the EMF, but...
is truly terrifying.
What is that? Oh, that's a light switch. Yeah, right. So because there's like a guy that can come over from, you know, up there. It's strange. In the first game, you could actually like stick to a wall and then equip yourself with a pistol, shoot around corners. But I guess you can't do that in this game. They removed quite a few features from each game, to be honest. Yeah, so the guy who comes around from the other building, he can't see us. So it's best to be a little cautious for this. Actually, yeah, let me just go ahead and turn the lights off here. Nothing there. Darkness, my ally. Can I not open it? Thank you. And suddenly everything starts shining. I would rather stick to the bottom where there are shadows rather than go out in the open into the light. Right then. No, I'm just gonna...
moving around out there? Who? I don't know who. That's why I'm worried.
Good thing to be worried about, sir. Very good thing to be worried about. There seems to be... yeah, there is a mic inside that thing there. Might as well remove it while these guys are distracted. And head upstairs.
That's the last microphone, Fisher. Otomo will be happy.
Otomo doesn't seem like the happy type.
It's just the old samurai Zan Shin. He's really nice in person.
I've heard people say the same thing about Lambert.
What does that mean? Lambert's nice.
How many of his ex-wives have you spoken to?
Sort of see it at the wrong point there. But yeah. We have to go through there, and I recall there being something here inside, but the game did say that I got the lost microphone, so maybe we don't need to go ahead and get that microphone, whatever it might be, wherever it might be. Go on then, I'm waiting for you to go inside. Good job, son. Come on, Sam. Get a move on. We need to get you into the shadows before these guys can notice us. And with the microphones out of the way, it is a pretty simple game from here. Nothing for us to sneak by using. I guess I'll just wait here until a later point in time when I can actually get all the way there. Yeah, too late to actually make a move now. These guys are completely oblivious to our presence, aren't they? Just the way I like it. Just the way I like it. I'm gonna wait for that guy to move. Alright.
Fisher, satellite imaging shows you're nearing some kind of tea house.
Zerkheizi's inside?
That's our best guess. Gather as much info as you can before making your move. We might only get one shot at this.
This section, right. We're near the end of the game. This level has, like, yes, lots of set pieces.
Douglas?
What?
The Koreans, they couldn't have. Douglas, I need to know the truth.
The truth? Did Oppenheimer know the truth? What about Roosevelt? Abe, truth is what we need it to be. And the truth is, we did the right thing.
What do you mean?
Proof of concept worked. It was ugly, sure, but it's over now.
You mean there will be peace?
Oh, no.
Well, peace isn't something that just happens, Abe. It has to be enforced, just like in the old days. You know, sheriff wears a shield, sure, but he also wears a gun.
Gun?
That's right.
Oh, my God.
And we can't have that gun falling into the wrong hands, can we now, Abe?
What are you... No!
My God, Fisher! Don't let Shetland escape!
Is he a target?
He's the target!
Let's try this here. Yeah, I guess that guy's vision cone is like severely limited to where he can't really see us. Can I not like slide this closed? Apparently not. That's the sword that Shetland used. We can move faster at this point in time. And we're out here. Gee. What's illuminating all of this? A firelight. Yes, we cannot do anything about that. Except for just sticking to the wall and trying to move as slowly as possible.
Damn it, he's gone. There was no way you could have stopped him. Complete the rest of the mission. I'll see if we can track him.
So what is the rest of the mission, pray tell? Let me just check the goals here.
That's all your primary objectives, Fisher. We could extract you at any time.
Alright.
No secondaries, and that's it. Should I save you? Nah. So there, you can actually go under the thing over there and infiltrate through that side. And there's like this guy waiting there, this gun on the ready. I don't know why he's doing that, but yeah, he's sort of waiting there. So if we go here, that guy should not be able to see us, and neither should that guy. So I think I'm gonna chance going through this side. Right, and we extract the same way that we came in, from behind the same guy, essentially. Alright, I'm gonna save here. And we are going to cautiously make it down these steps, because that guy's still there. If you take that guy out, it's a very simple thing, really. But unfortunately, we have not taken that guy out, so yeah, we need to rely on a ton of shenanigans. Let me save here again. Like, whenever I'm unsure of anything, I'd like to just save scum. It honestly saves me a bit of progress every single time, which adds up to a lot. Wrong key there. Yeah, I'm trying to see if there's a way that I could employ over here. Seems to be. That was the part that I was trying to take even the first time around, to be honest. And we are well hidden in the shrubbery right now. Best to take this slow. Do not want that guy on us, noticing us. Zerkheizi is dead. He was being strung along by Shetland, who gave him some kind of false hope about something. And I'm just gonna wait. Yeah, and I'm just gonna wait here for a bit. Until this guy decides to look away again, and then we are free to go. So, Zerkheizi was being strung along by Shetland, who gave him hopes of world peace. Utilizing the mask and also world peace, I mean. And we're clear. At this point, we just call for extraction. This mission was a failure, to be honest. But that is what this mission is. That is the ebb and flow of chaos theory. You don't always get exactly what you want in this mission. We had been chasing leads, and the leads gave us what we wanted. But the mission was still a failure. We went in to abduct Zerkheizi, but Zerkheizi got killed by Shetland. And we, however, did discover the real identity of Milo Nedich, that is Milos Novak, the Bosnian barber, and we eliminated him. However, we could not eliminate Douglas Shetland after we found out that he was crooked. And here's the thing, though, I mean, Sam sort of overheard the conversation between Nedich and Douglas, and he got the gist that Douglas was actually coming over to tie up loose ends, as Nedich explained to his subordinate. Which was later confirmed by the fact that Nedich actually confirmed that Shetland was the boss. So why did the Third Echelon have to phone Sam in and explicitly tell him again that Shetland is on his way via helicopter? Anyhow, so this was it for Mission Hokkaido. Hokkaido? Yeah, Hokkaido. I don't think this mission had any opportunity objectives. bonus objectives. But if it did, well, we missed them. So anyhow, things are getting tense right now. Things are getting really tense right now. And when we get back, we will be, enemies that you eliminate as a part of an objective do not count towards your global score. So yeah, when we get back, we will be covering the next mission, which I do believe is Seoul, because of the missile strike that you guys saw in the cinematic right before this mission. There was a missile strike that took place, and we need to get to the bottom of it by going to Seoul to access a military server that is otherwise inaccessible through the air because it is air-gapped. So yeah, we need to get that server, and relay the data back home. But things get a little twisted in that, in that plan as well. Things don't exactly go as planned. After all, it is currently a war zone at this point in time, between the North Korea and between North Korea and South Korea. So yeah, that's a thing. Anyway, as far as Mission Hokkaido is concerned, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. Until next time, when we meet in Seoul, South Korea, take care, fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.